Linda, a very sad day for all the medical personnel gathered at Milpark. What can you tell us?
Well, Sally, a very sad day, but not only for those that are gathered here. We understand, in fact, that across all industries, there has been messages that have been shared, paying homage and respect to those that were on what we understand now was a massive flight. But just a moment ago, a short ceremony, just paying respects and tributes to those that were on that particular plane. And as you mentioned, all of those names, one by one, that's exactly what was happening earlier on. And then there was a moment of silence, about a minute, just paying their respect to those that had fallen. But we are with the CEO of Netcare, that's Richard Friedland. Thank you so much, sir, for joining us. And I guess we should just get into the details of the fact that it was a massive flight. Explain to us what that means, sir.
So our five colleagues took off from this hospital, Milpark, Netcare Milpark Hospital, to save a patient. He was 51 years old, who was dying of COVID, and to put him onto an ECMO machine. That's a very sophisticated heart-lung bypass machine, because he was already being ventilated. And we were flying down to KwaZulu-Natal, to Hilton. This is our specialist team to pick him up. And tragically, there was a catastrophic accident between Bergville and Ladysmith, and they were killed instantly on this flight.
And one of the things that you mentioned while you were speaking to some of the colleagues gathered here was, in fact, to touch on the devastation that you've seen in the past year dealing with COVID-19. And I mean, you're bowing your heads today, but just give us a sense of the devastation, not just from this incident, but from battling COVID-19, how it's been, the colleagues that you've lost. Just give us a sense of
that. Right across the country, both in the public and the private sectors, healthcare workers are our true frontline heroes. And they have borne the brunt of this terrible pandemic. Just as we were consoling our staff here at Netcare Milpark this morning, we lost another colleague. And when we gave the eulogy for these five colleagues, we were giving a eulogy for five more colleagues within our own organization who had passed away this week. And right across all of the groups, public and private, our healthcare workers have sacrificed their lives in order to keep all South Africans safe. And so our hearts are broken. And today we pay tribute to them as well. And we bow our heads in respect to them as well.
And while you pay tribute, one of the things you mentioned earlier on while addressing some of the staff here at Netcare was to say what do we do now? Where do we go from here? What is the answer? Do we push on while there's a pandemic such as this one? But you spoke of, in fact, the fact that this is actually the calling for many of the frontline workers across the country.
Correct. This is our calling. This is what we are purposed for as healthcare workers. And in that I include everyone in the chain, be they porters or cleaners or admin staff, paramedics, doctors or nurses. And this is our calling. And so when people say, how do we continue in the face of this tragedy, the pain that we face every day, we have to continue. And we have to honor the memory of those who have fallen, and to honor their memory and know that this is why we are here. This is our purpose. This is our calling. And our colleagues who died on the helicopter yesterday answered the highest calling. There can be no greater sacrifice than losing your life whilst trying to save another. And hence, we hold in our hearts the families of the loved ones who have been left behind in this tragedy, and all of our healthcare workers across South Africa.
And this trip was, in fact, from one particular operation trying to save one life and towards trying to save another life. But I just want you to give us a sense of the fact that we do understand that one of the doctors was, in fact, with the minister trying to save that particular life, but also moving to a critical patient. Just give us a sense, if you can, if this is possible, as to whether that particular patient had received the help timely that the particular helicopter was trying to deliver that side.
Well, you're absolutely correct that our late minister was in our hospital, was critically ill. We had airlifted him with that same helicopter from Steve Biko on Tuesday night, and we brought him to our hospital. And one of our doctors, as you've pointed out, was involved in his resuscitation. Unfortunately, that was not successful. And we've tried our best with this patient who's critically ill. He's still alive, and mercy of God, he will survive.
Just very quickly, I'm out of time, but I do have to slot in this one. out there, there is, of course, conspiracies going around and around COVID-19. You are, and many of your colleagues are in the front lines seeing the devastation of this particular pandemic. If you can just give us a sense of clarity to say this pandemic is exactly as perceived by many of the practitioners out there.
Absolutely. There are no conspiracy theories. This is real. This is a plague. If you have to look 1 year ago to this day, there were 555 cases in the world. Today we have nearly 95 million cases across the world, and 2 million people have died. And we only have to listen to the leadership of our own Minister of Health and others in following their lead. We need to be cautious. This is a virus that kills people. It's killing our people. It's killing our healthcare workers. And that's why we beg people to maintain non-pharmaceutical measures. Wear your masks. Maintain social distancing. Wash your hands. And until we have a vaccine, that is going to be absolutely critical.
All right, thank you so much for giving us your time at such a difficult time, in fact, and for waiting for us, Sally. That's the message from the CEO of Netcare, that's Richard Friedland, saying that this is real. Many people are with their conspiracy theories, but at the end of the day, personally for myself as well, being in this space, seeing the faces of many of the health practitioners today, I can certainly tell you that the devastation is felt from those on the front line. And today, paying homage to some of those that are constantly in the line of duty, making sure that they heal some of the members of the communities that are battling with this particular virus.
Linda, thank you so much. And such a powerful message coming from Richard Friedland of Netcare, saying we have to continue. We simply have no other choice. And he makes it so clear that a year ago there were 555 cases, and there are now 95 million cases across the globe. And let's just listen to the names of those people on that chopper who died, and the poignant news that one of those doctors, Rudolph Mononyane, had also tried to assist Jackson Mtembu before he died. So those healthcare workers we've lost, Dr. Rudolph Mononyane, Dr. Siya Mahlangu, specialist theatre nurse Mpho Xaba, paramedic Sinjin Farrance, and pilot Mark Stox-reiter. They died in the line of duty. They were in that chopper helping critically ill people, most of them COVID-19 patients, when their chopper went down in Bergville in KwaZulu-Natal.